understanding what God's house is supposed to be will help you understand why Jesus got so upset. He's saying this is what it's supposed to be, a house of prayer. People are supposed to be able to come here and communicate with God and talk to God, and you've made it a den of thieves. Look at Isaiah 56, verse number 4. The Bible says, "For thus saith the Lord, unto the eunuchs that keep my Sabbaths, and choose the things that please me, and take hold of my covenant, even unto them will I give in mine house and within my walls a place and a name better than of sons and of daughters. I will give them an everlasting name that shall not be cut off." Also, and again, I mean, this is an everlasting name. We see everlasting life in the Old Testament. We don't see ever the possibility of anyone losing their salvation. He says, "I will give them an everlasting name that shall not be cut off." Yeah. They can't remove that name, right? All the Old Testament's not like, oh no, they had to do a sacrifice in order to be cleansed from their sin. No, they didn't. Not for their eternal salvation. Verse number 6, "Also the sons of the stranger that join themselves to the Lord." Now that word stranger there, that just means like a foreigner. That means someone who's not physically descended of Israel or of Abraham. It's just someone that's a stranger. It's just someone that comes and joins themselves to the land. It says also the sons of the stranger that join themselves to the Lord. So people that come and they want to worship God, they come and join themselves to the Lord to serve him and to love the name of the Lord, to be his servants. "Everyone that keepeth the Sabbath from polluting it and taketh hold of my covenant, even them will I bring to my holy mountain and make them joyful in my house of prayer. Their burnt offerings and their sacrifices shall be accepted upon mine altar. For mine house shall be called an house of prayer for all people. The Lord God, which gathereth the outcasts of Israel, saith, yet will I gather others to him beside those that are gathered unto him." Now, I want to point out real quick that this chapter is real clear. We had someone come and visit our church one time who thought that the only people that were saved were literal, physical descendants of Israel. He says that's it. And of course, he thought that he was a physical descendant of Israel. I mean, I don't know anyone who believes that. That doesn't believe that they're one of the physical descendants. But he had this whole, I mean, he was a white guy too. Some white guy saying he's a physical, okay, well, whatever. Well, he you know what though? He's just as much a physical descendant of Israel as I am, or as anyone is here, you know, probably just because of the mixing and everything else, that I don't see him having any more or any less than just about anyone else in this room. So, anyways, it was kind of dumb because he was really just ignorant of the scripture. He's been taught this, and he had a few places that he would try to reference and try to cite, but overall the argument was really lacking. And what we see here in Isaiah 56, he says, look, God's house is a house of prayer unto all nations. This isn't exclusive just for the physical seed of Abraham or just for the physical seed of Israel, right? This isn't just for the Jews, because he's saying, look, a stranger, a foreigner, someone born in another land, not someone of the seed of Israel. If they come and they join themselves unto the Lord and they want to serve him, great. He says, my house is a house of prayer for all people, all nations, not just the nation of Israel. No, it's for all nations. But what they had to do then was, because they didn't really have the local churches the way that it's set up now, they would go to Israel. They would go to the temple or the tabernacle, however, depending on when they were living, to go and join themselves to become, you know, to serve the Lord. And that's just what they would do. But it even says in verse 8, the Lord God, which gathereth the outcasts of Israel. So, oh yeah, that's talking about the outcasts of Israel. Yes, it is. Saith, yet will I gather others to him, beside those that are gathered unto him. So besides even the outcasts, because what they'll try to say is, oh, these people that are the strangers coming from other lands, they were still descendants of Israel, but they had just moved away and now they're coming back, which would be the outcasts of Israel we see here. But he says, even in verse number 8, he says, yet will I gather others to him. And this is the very reason why I don't believe in segregated churches. You know, there's churches today that are like, you have a black congregation and a Hispanic congregation and a Polish congregation or whatever it may be. It doesn't matter. You know, people like to segregate and say, you know, yeah, this is just a black church. I thought it's God's house is supposed to be a house of prayer for all people.
Yeah.
Because your race, your skin color, the pigmentation that you have, where you were born, doesn't matter. And it's even Old Testament, New Testament, for in Christ there is neither Jew nor Greek. There's neither bond nor free, male nor female. Look, if you're saved and you're, you know, you're a believer in Christ, church is for you. And no one should be excluded from that. That's why we don't exclude anyone based on race or anything like that. It's pretty ridiculous. But this is where we get this quote from. He's saying, look, my house should be called a house of prayer for all people. It's a place where you can go and you know, it's also interesting too, because he mentions in this verse about the people that want to come. It says to keep my Sabbaths. Verse number 6, also the sons of the strangers that join themselves to the Lord to serve him and to love the name of the Lord, to be his servants, everyone that keepeth the Sabbath from polluting it and taketh hold of my covenant, even them will I bring to my holy mountain. So he's talking about people who are doing all of these things, right? These people that want to join themselves, they want to serve him, they love the name of the Lord, they're keeping the Sabbaths, you know, and they're trying to do what's right. Hey, that's what the house of God is for. It's for prayer, it's for serving God and for, you know, and doing all the things that he listed off here.